Now every gambler knows the secret to surviving is knowing what to throw away, knowing what to keep. 'Cause every hand's a winner and every hand's a loser, and the best you can hope for is to die.
All right, welcome to the Diplomats. You know, one of the things I've learned about life is you don't always have to be on. I'm not going to be on time. I took time off for a little vacation. We're catching up. We're going at our own pace. If the players in Olympus Season 2 main event can ask for extensions, live their own best life, so can the Diplomats.
Aren't they asking for another extension soon anyways? We'll be caught up in no time.
Yeah. No, we're not too far behind. But if they don't give us courtesy, we don't give them courtesy. I'm sorry, Jordan. I know you beg for this stuff because you're an intention. Welcome to the Diplomats. Welcome to Season 2 Olympus main event. We're covering maybe a good game. We're not sure yet. Seemed like it started out okay, then kind of got boring. Now it's getting okay again. With Keith, Superstition, Stitches, Don, man of many names, coming to us from North Carolina late at night.
It's 9:59. Late at night.
I'm 52. That's late for me. All right. Last did this, we did spring 1908. As we can see here, we have the stab. We have the Jordan stab on Riaz, and we both thought it was ill-timed. We've got Turkey moving on against Russia here, and we have Russia with troubles against Turkey, but pressing on, trying to be a player in the West, accepting support into Kiel. We talked about Denmark, a lot of options. Have I reoriented you to this game?
Yep. I am slowly remembering. It's been a minute.
We were on vacation. So let's go and see how fall 1908 worked.
Have we already gone over spring?
Yeah, we did it. It was a 7-minute video. We did this.
7 minutes.
Yeah, I know. And that was with Cedric, 7 minutes. There's not much to say. I mean, look at this, okay?
Yeah. I mean, Italy jockeys for position a little bit. There's a Turkish stab. Russia sees it coming, already DMZing versus Italy to have a place to retreat. Yeah, we did talk about the army. It's just interesting that Riaz is pushing Russia when France is coming up behind him. So it's
well,
either.
Let's see what happens in the fall. And, the first thing I notice is English get back into Kiel. That's where they decided to go, right? And because there's a self-bounce in Berlin, Kiel's disbanded.
Yep.
I think that's pretty helpful for Riaz to get one army out of there.
Well,
it'll be helpful for Russia.
It almost pulls Russia completely out of the middle. He gets back in the Baltic. It's a slightly more secure place. It can't be a good feeling for Riaz to have those French fleets all around him.
Yeah, I mean, well, there's only two French.
I know, but they're not in great spots. You see Riaz is moving to cover.
Admittedly, he's got to play D here.
He's down one. He loses Holland.
Yes. I have to remember that we were looking at a spring season before. I have to remember that the stab was for two.
And with him as in North Atlantic, I mean, Conn can easily say, I have to build, even though he could just back away.
Yeah, I think Jordan has to build a fleet. Oh, this is going to be a tricky disband for React.
Yep.
What to disband?
Well, if he's trusting Russia again, which I don't know.
I don't think so.
If the move to Livonia is a trustworthy one or not, I'm not sure. But if he does,
I think he has to get rid of
Denmark. Is the one. But
why do you want an army in Denmark? Probably the fleet.
Yeah, I would keep the fleet. Even if France kicks you out, you can go back. It's not looking really good for Riaz here. I really feel like he needs to pick his winner. At this point, I don't know if he has the pride to do that. So he might just try to survive the best he can, whatever he can, and let them figure it out.
I don't know. Riaz is a next level thinker. So I don't think he's just like me, like pick a winner and turn him. Like he's got some other magic, right? You know, he has something better than what I can. And he really doesn't want to work with Jordan. Like, is there any way, like, of like who's done him the dirtiest? They've both done him pretty dirty, but dirtiest is Jordan.
Yeah. I mean, he's always stabbing him, putting him in the positions and moving forward. I mean, Riaz might be more bitter towards Russia because they actually had a working relationship that he trashed. But in the end, I was like, France has never been your friend. So.
Meanwhile, let's look at Russia here. It's kind of a ballsy move going Sweden to Baltic. I knew it was done right, but you don't 100% know what Riaz is going to do. That was lucky. But Ukraine not supporting Romania. Like, what am I? I guess he's really worried and Galicia has to go to Silesia. So Galicia and Ukraine are not supporting Romania.
I guess
that's the idea.
That's a
It seems
big
like a
mistake.
mistake to me.
I'm like, Berlin's pretty much all but lost. The Livonia move is weird. That makes me feel like he's back with England again. When they just bounced to Norway, he could have taken it with either of them. I'm like, if you're trying to save Kiel, then why don't you just support your way into Norway and just say, hey, have Kiel. I don't care. But had he tapped Denmark, he would have kept Kiel
Kiel.
and Berlin. So.
I think it's a series of guesses with high risk gambles, which is something that new players do a lot.
I'm going to say the ER is back here because there's just no reason not to attack Norway here, at least with St. Petersburg. I mean, Riaz is on a full pivot. It just,
Okay,
I don't.
that's a good. That might explain the moves. It doesn't explain what happened with Galicia and Ukraine. And look at Grayson. Either he got information or the guy knows how, because now Seb is lost, right? I mean, I guess it's sort of,
He just
with.
assumed it would cover and he followed him over. I mean, Black can't be dislodged. So what's Ankara going to do? I mean, it's going to. I mean, I don't know if that's a huge play by Grayson. It's like Ankara can either go to Armenia or hold. You don't really want to go to Khan because in the weird situation that Armenia goes to Ankara, then not fun to use two units to get back out.
But it's not even a lay and pray strategy. He's not even supporting it. I don't understand. Like, why is he going to Silesia? Is he worried that Russia's going? I mean, that France is going there?
Yeah, I'm assuming he's afraid France is going to try to surround Berlin here. Or, yeah, because no one can force a retreat. It doesn't make much sense to me why Romania is not.
Meanwhile, typical Ewok doesn't have to do any work and just walks into Silesia.
Serbia.
Serbia, sorry. Now all of a sudden he got a sixth dot, right?
Yep. And he's tapped Budapest and sure Romania fell, which wasn't 100%, but it is when everything's pivoting away. I wouldn't have left my southern front. Right now, you have two units up north holding three, and really, it's at everyone's whim of what takes what. So if you can just stoke the anti-England and France and make them go against each other, you need to hold your southern front until Italy or Turkey actually commit to the other side. I think he didn't look like he had any friends. He had no supports going into Italy or Turkey. So why would you just abandon your line? I don't understand. He needs them to get frustrated and worry about time.
Who are you talking about?
Russia, it's got all five units sitting there. None of the supports are helping Italy. None of the supports are helping Turkey. So he has made no diplomatic gains with either. So if he has no friends in Italy or Turkey, then he should be using his units to save the majority of his centers in the southern flank. I'm like, screw Berlin. I'm like, it's gonna fall.
I couldn't agree that I couldn't agree with you more there. Unless it's an ER, right? But if it's an ER, why is St. Petersburg not going to Moscow? I don't get it. And
It gives him some play if Kiel's still there, or even if Kiel's not. I mean, the convoy through Baltic can go back to Sweden if Riaz pivoted wrong, or it could work with France again and take something else that Baltic touches. So it's not a horrible spot, but like the only thing the North makes sense is if it's in tandem with England, which is the worst off again on again relationship I've ever seen. I'm just it's like you guys together or not. So,
God, what do you do if you're Italy here? This is a hard call. You've got to build. The threat right now is Jordan and Turkey. He's got two threats on the board. He's between both. I think he has to build fleet naval. But I could see a case for an army, given that the armies are going to be vulnerable to Turkey.
I built an army here, just because I think that you got to get that fleet out of Venice. If you can pivot your fleets around, you don't really need more than three right now, but I think an army would help shore up his Balkan territory enough to let his fleets get out before he's under pressure. It's his turn to pivot. He's got to pivot. He's got to get his fleets in the more useful positions. And if he's in Tyrrhenian, Ionian, Adriatic, he can be able to shift east or west to try to control the board the best he can. He just needs that one army to really hold his position.
Is Russia flat because Kiel got piffed? We lost Romania. I think
Yeah,
that's right.
Russia's flat.
We agree France has to
You
build
have done
fleet
an A.
burst.
Fleet burst. Yep. What is. Riaz disbanded. I would assume he disbands his army, but he might want that to support Kiel.
I think it depends on his relationship with Russia.
Yep.
But
I would say it has to be an army, Denmark or London. Just depends on his relationships. Three units on Kiel, though.
I probably get rid of Kiel's only useful to retreat to Helgoland.
Yeah,
I
but if
don't
Push is on your side, he's in Baltic, he can help support it.
know. I go Army Denmark. I think three armies for England in the spot is not good,
I'd probably do Army London. He's already got an army on the island.
You think Army Rome or Army Naples? Maybe Army Naples for another.
I would do Rome just because I want to pivot and fat, and I'd rather just have Rome walk.
Pivot where?
What's that?
Pivot where?
The
Towards France?
Tyrrhenian Sea. I mean, if you're an Ionian and Tyrrhenian, you can go to east or west. After. It's a
It's
neutral
true.
position. It's something I think Greg would do as Italy is to, hey, I have a secure position. Finally, I'm just going to pivot my fleets into a more useful position that's very ambiguous, and then I can go either way.
Here's my thinking. Whatever Italy builds, Turkey builds. It's going to be two armies or two fleet. And if we see it different, if we see army fleet, it means grace and lie.
I can see that.
That's my that's how I'm going with it. Because I don't think I've never had Greg lie to me about a build. He's lied in a game rarely. He's not really a liar type. He's just more like, no, I can't do it.
I think Turkey beats Army Khan here, or Army Ankara, just for the convoy to Sev, because I think it's guaranteed.
Yeah, I think Sev's guaranteed. If I
And
have
why would
to.
I not want to drop an army in there right now? Granted, you could always support Romania up there, but the Balkans are holding pretty strong.
Why didn't Turkey get a build here?
Oh, he gave up Serbia.
That's right. All right. Fleet Naples.
Wow.
Oh my God.
There goes Liverpool.
Yeah, it makes sense. Now that I look at it, it
I
makes
figured it would
sense.
be an army, and I guess covering with North is more risky than North Atlantic, so.
Yeah, it makes sense. And Irish is unlikely to. Yeah, this is all very reasonable. I think based on what we've seen. Okay, I mean we're looking here. Josh is still in first place with the tiebreaker,
He is.
but it's a long way from 10, which is where he was. I think he might have. Did he ever get up to 11?
No,
No.
these are very weak too.
Got to give him a grade for 1907, or sorry, 1908. We're down one again. Down Romania, Turkey, Italy. Look at that. Remember that line that he had all the way from Sweden down to Black Sea, I think.
Yeah.
And this is looking like Russia in 1941 here. July. Things are not looking good on the front. Got to give him a grade. Still our leader.
Give him an F. I don't really care. He has no allies, and if he does have an ally, it's with England. He has stabbed a few times already, and if he's just lost Kiel back, it's fine. You're going with England, but if England's your only ally, then you don't move your units away from your enemies and lose centers. It doesn't make any sense because by losing Romania, now he's pretty much lost Sevastopol. So you kind of have to see this as the cascading wheel of doom that has become this downward spiral. And I don't know if he's going to be able to recover. I mean, where's his growth? There's no one fighting, and there's nowhere where he can gain any opportunities. He made a
He
really big mistake stabbing Italy.
needs a friend in the north because Jordan is not a long-term fit for him. And that's got to be Riaz. I don't know if he's going to turn it. He had a diplomatic goal. His diplomatic goal should have been to work with Italy against Turkey.
Yep.
That should have been what he needed. Now, maybe he couldn't do it, but that's on him, but on the other hand, he's still leading. I'm going to give him a D. He's not an F for me. I mean, I think though that the Galicia-Ukraine moves were inexplicable.
Tactic-wise, it was very
Inexplicable.
bad. Diplomatic-wise, seemed.
And now there's no credible defense against Turkey. It's not like what attack can there be made on Turkey right now? Like honestly, it's just going to be a feeding frenzy for his dots because he didn't support Romania.
Yep. And yeah, they have three in Budapest, which can be stopped, but like I said, Sevastopol.
You're going to take, I mean, I don't know what happened. He's taking Sevastopol. Like,
He's taken Sevastopol.
that's
For,
happened.
and then maybe next year, Vienna and Budapest will fall. He's just going to be relegated to the north. I'm sure Berlin's not for this world, so he might be a force in Russia by the end of this game.
I mean, we're going to learn a lot by how he take it with fleet, which he probably won't do. He's going to probably have to make Romania the mover, which is bad news for Russia. Certain. Well,
I'd like to
I
see
mean,
Greg move into East and convoy to Syria.
I would too.
But
But
that's a very unlikely to happen. But
I don't think that's gonna happen.
I just think that a six center Turkey is a little menacing if I
Well,
want
yeah,
to land
once he closes
easily.
that circle that we were talking about in the last thing, closing that circle around the black, then you start thinking about Turkish win. And there's 4 years to go. 4 years with a crumbling Russia, Sevastopol, Warsaw, Moscow. And the traditional path for Turkey is the southern one, Serbia, Trieste. I mean, there's a lot of dots available. for Turkey here.
Even if he
Which,
holds Sevastopol in Serbia, he's at nine.
but
So,
we gotta move on to Jordan. France now second place with eight centers. It's been a hard game for Jordan. We've been hard on him. This stab looks like it's worked out, sort of. It's a grind stab. I don't know if that's what you call it or Cedric, but it is a grind stab. This isn't going to
It
be.
is a grind stab.
He's got the upper hand, but
It's like I
man,
said
oh man.
before, I'm like, Russia should have recognized a long time ago that without Italy, France is going to be hard to stop. There's no Germany. Russia just can't have that board presence in the middle. It's just not going to happen.
I mean, the real love story here is between France and Italy.
Yeah.
I mean, it's a real love story. There's not been one hostile move between the two of them. I don't know if the stab was well timed or not. And I think ultimately, we made fun of Conk in the last thing, saying he couldn't keep it in his pants. But I'm looking at this and I'm like, that's like beyond a stalemate line in the center of the board. Okay, he's not going to lose anything. And yeah, he's a little. It'd be nice to have one more fleet. Nice to have four fleets in this situation against England's four.
Right.
But it's advantage Conk. I mean, I'm going to go B plus.
I like it a lot. He's been playing both sides against each other as much as possible and just creating windows of opportunity. And he's trying to exploit all of them. And he doesn't really care because I mean, there's three of them. Even if they both work against him, he's just got the upper hand. He has eight units to pressure all of England's six and then what, two? So it's 8 on 8. So if he can just con them into helping him every other turn, he can make periodic growth. I mean, the rest of those Russian armies are south. Granted, Russia did pivot another one in, so 8 versus, but it's pretty good. I like it a lot. It's slow and grueling, but
If I'm not mistaken, moving up from I think at one point in sixth, maybe seventh, now to third is Turkey with the tiebreak. Only two centers behind with one in hand for Sevastopol. A little guesswork on Romania, depending on Italy. What's your grade? Did you give
oh
your grade to France other than I liked it a lot?
well. I didn't. I'm gonna give it, yeah, I guess I'll give it a B plus too. It's a good score, but he still has no super ally. This is all tactics right now. So someone can give the game away that has a better relationship. And I don't think he's got that social capital.
Okay, Turkey's great.
I love Turkey. It's an A for me. He's got Sevastopol in the bag, which is gonna put him at seven and put Russia down one. His only real threat is France right now. And I think that he just has better growth opportunities than France does.
It's an A triple plus with a smiley face, exclamation point. First of all, this is an IT at 6-6 that is in Turkey's favor.
Yeah.
I think the big challenge for Grayson is going to be what happens when Greg wants Greece, because that's the next ask. And I've been in this situation, and I kind of gave in to Greg until I couldn't give in to Greg anymore. And I don't know how Grayson will. Something tells me he'll be a little more obstinate than I am. I don't know.
Yeah, I think if I'm Greg, I ask for Greece here. If I don't get Greece, then I consider it war. I need to be bigger as Italy than Turkey, especially if I need to pivot to France. So,
I can hear it all. Whether Greg will actually ever pivot towards France, I don't know. I don't think Greg has any dots over there. I think, yeah, I can slow down Jordan, but how does that help me win?
well, that's why you need the extra dots to do that. Even if he had one fleet over there just to poke him, it would make him pull back a lot more. And granted, you don't want France to come down, but at the same time, I mean, England wants him out too. So he can't fully commit south. It's just not going to happen. You just need one fleet to make him use two or three to stop you.
Yeah.
And
All right, time.
that gives both Italy and Turkey opportunities to win by hampering France just a little bit. Great
Greg.
for Greg. I'm going to give him a B. Solid growth. Positioning's getting better. Negotiated his growth, has an ally. I just don't like his ally. I wish he would have. I wish, well, not that I don't dislike his ally. Just at this point, I think it would have been better for him to pivot back to Russia, but
How
it
can you not give Greg an A?
is.
He's back in this game with a shitty fleet position, no diplomatic leverage. I mean, I
But
guess he had some leverage, right? Turkey kind of had it against Serbia because of the risk to Turkey, right? That was a smart thing for Grayson to do.
I mean, Greg at this point will only grow either by luck or by charity. It's like, I don't think he forces anything.
I
He
wish I could
likes
grow by
the
charity.
armies to really hit Russia without Turkish help. So that has to be gifted. If he wants Greece, that has to be gifted. Or if he goes west, that's just he's just got to get lucky and walk into one and fall. So, I mean, he kind of stops at sick until the diplomacy kicks in. I think if he was with Russia, he'd have a little bit more chances. But I mean, Russia's a dangerous thing to play with right now. He's stabbing everybody and he's big. But once Russia goes down one more center and loses Sevastopol, I mean, he's not your number one target anymore. That's Turkey. So I just don't envy Italy having to balance both France and Turkey and trying to win on top of it.
England's been my side piece pick. Actually, I think Jordan might have been my first side piece, and then it was Riaz, my second side piece. He's now in fifth out of five players with the tiebreak. Technically, you could say he's second place, two centers behind, but it's looking bad. Steele's looking bad. Mid-Atlantic safe. All those armies. He's impenetrable. I mean, even if Naples go to Tyrrhenian, there's Burgundy that could go to Gascony and,
I'm
solve
sure he's
problems.
been begging for help, begging. I know Italy's not going to play someone else's game, so it's got to be good for Italy.
Yeah, that's the one guy you can't sway with it emotionally.
Nope.
That's the one guy
He's
like,
like, I hear you. That sucks.
yeah, too
Probably
bad. Remember when things were bad for me? I
here.
couldn't, because no, like if it's in Greg's interest, Greg will go.
Yeah.
But I don't, I think Greg will go to Tyrrhenian. That makes sense.
He'll go to Tyrrhenian. I don't know if he'll go further. It'll be enough just to pull a unit back to Gascony, maybe, but France
Look,
can't afford to do.
I think it's going to be just what Greg wants, right? Which is he'll go to Tyrrhenian. There'll be some dumbass bounce in Western Med for 2 years.
Is it if he gets from Greece? I mean, sure. Bouncing Western Med for 2 years.
Riaz is great. Gets sort of luckily bamboozled here that he didn't get to Denmark. Fine, he got killed back. I can't really fault him for fall 1908.
France tried to hold
Here's
him there too.
the problem. Here's the issue. I mean, he deserves an F, and I think he's the best player. I think he's shown himself to be the best player in this game with all the tap dancing, but the tap dancing's run out. It's an F.
I think he got too emotional when Russia stabbed him, and he was thinking more personal game-wise, and that allowed France to get a jump on him that he shouldn't have. Especially when Russia showed that they were going to do anything to repair that relationship, and he still stabbed. It looks like it's still stabbed, but I do not like it. I don't see a way for him to come back. He could hold his centers, and the only thing he could really take is Russian centers. And even then, I don't know if it gets him enough. They would
No,
almost
it's
have to
really
throw.
bad. It's really bad.
Those dots would have to be thrown, basically.
What's the grade?
I'm gonna give it an F. I think he played short-tempered, and that wasn't a good idea. He's been playing very masterfully the entire time.
Who will win? Who will win? You've been with Russia the whole time. It's a
No,
question
I
we
switched
ask
to
at the end of the.
Turkey. I switched to Turkey after that stab.
I know that I was right in the sense that I picked Turkey and France the whole game. It's going to be Turkey or France. But I don't think it's an easy call as to which one.
I'm gonna pick Turkey. I think Riaz just plays for his best position. I mean, at this point, he might threaten the throw, but I still think he's just gonna keep it the best score possible, and I think that's gonna hold.
For a taste of your whiskey, I'll give you some advice. You got to know when to hold 'em, know when to fold 'em, know when to walk away, know when to run. You never count your money when you're sitting at the table. There'll be time enough for counting when the dealing's done.